13 home games in the Premier League against Liverpool. And they've also improved, and this has been crucial as well this season, against the big six sides. They've won three of their seven.
So I'm Steve Arson, a Manchester United fan. I've been going since 1990 when my dad took me as a six-year-old. I think I've got my programme actually through there, I think. I've definitely got my granddad's first programme, which is 1950. So my granddad took my dad, he took me. Lifelong United fan, lifelong family of United fans.
With my grandfather and with my own son Jaden, to pass on that knowledge and stress the importance of keeping that knowledge alive for the modern fan.
史蒂芬内尔森是个每一天都会处在狂欢状态的超级球迷，因为在 YouTube 上，内尔森每天所发出的每一个视频都会迎来和他一样的球迷粉丝们的关注和分享。
I never would have imagined that I would enjoy talking, giving my opinion on football, and there's no way that I thought I'd be able to sit here. And even 6 months ago, I didn't think I'd be sitting in my own studio in the centre of Manchester to doing this thing.
史蒂芬内尔森的 YouTube 频道已经开通半年了。最让他兴奋的是，目前的20,000多粉丝中，很多是来自一线的球员。史蒂芬内尔森甚至执着地认为，自己比有些前职业选手更加懂得足球。
Because we're fans, because we're honest, we're the antithesis of TV. TV's got sponsorships to adhere to, and it's got biases that they need to adhere to, and agendas that they need to adhere to. Fan TV's from the heart, and actually there's some bloody good fanalysts, for a better word, people that create content that know what they're talking about. Yes, they're fans, they might not have played a professional game, but they understand football in a way that, embarrassingly, some professional ex-players really don't.
Leslie!
Today's the Manchester 是一个全世界足球希望开始的地方。90年代，曼联从这里走向整个欧洲。可以说，内尔森见证了曼联这支全球顶级球队最为疯狂生长的日子。
It's just been a part of my life since I've been born. I'm lucky enough to be born in Manchester, which is with what's happening with Manchester City becoming a hub of world football, the ascension's here. But I grew up in the 90s watching Sir Alex Ferguson's dominant Manchester United teams, watching Eric Cantona and Ryan Giggs and David Beckham and Roy Keane, and it was always, it didn't feel like it was a privilege at the time, it was just what you did. Like, I'm going watching United, I'm watching us in Europe, I'm watching us win Premier Leagues. I'm very fortunate, like I said, my first game was 1990. That kick-started the dominance that United had over English football and eventually Europe for that decade and beyond.
老特拉福德球场是曼联俱乐部的百年主场，内尔森的爷爷经常会带着内尔森的6岁的儿子守在这里，回顾曼联那段浴火重生的历史。
It's always going to be a part of my life. It always will be a part of my life. I took my own son at 14 months old. I think his program's in there as well. Actually, I've got all my dad's, my granddad's, and Jaden's. We're a whole family of football going Reds at the moment. We haven't got a season ticket for Jaden, but I still go to match with my dad. That's what it means to me. This is a thing that me and my dad have done growing up, and that's replicated thousands of times up and down this country, and in particular in this city.
慕尼黑事件是曼联历史上一场空前的劫难，这场意外让这支球队精英俱损。曼联这个老牌球队，并未在重伤中消沉下去，而是在不屈的呐喊中一度崛起，成就了今日雄踞足坛的世界顶级豪门球队。在死亡中重生的经历，锻造出百年红魔足坛史中的一段铁血传奇。史蒂芬内尔森四代人以及来自全世界各地的球迷们为曼联疯狂，为曼联同悲同喜，因为曼联的传奇征服了所有人。
I had a really good chat to my granddad about this. My granddad's got some really good thoughts on it. He said Manchester United belonged to Manchester before Munich. Everybody fell in love with what Manchester United was after what happened at Munich around the world. That story, that tragedy to triumph 10 years later winning the European Cup. The reason this is called Studio 68 is because of what that we did in 68. That whole story that takes you from the death of a club to the rebirth of a club to the triumph of a club. Everyone can get behind the story of Manchester United for that. And that's what makes it a special club. And that's why you can understand why people from all over the place guys. I was fortunate. I won the lottery by being born in Manchester, but you can absolutely understand the reason that people love this club from afar.
足球文化在内尔森的身上传递着，内尔森也把足球文化向更多的球迷传播和分享。在他的眼里，粉丝网站已经成为曼联足球文化的一部分，曼联不死的精神更多激励着内尔森对足球事业的执着追求。作为一个资深家族式的曼联粉丝，内尔森更加明白球迷的声音在足球文化中有着更为重要的价值。
Maybe that's where we have it. Joe, I don't like is I don't like that we go back and analyze that sort of stuff more than we analyze the tactics and the football and the gameplay and the skill that brought us the game. They spent more time on match of the day analyzing the foulsThen they did the brilliant football, the pass from Alexis Sanchez that Pogba rises to get on the end of. This is football. This isn't football. This is nonsense. This is football. Let's talk about football. That's what excites me about the game.